Hello everybody. In the last session, we have discussed about the characteristics of series electric circuit. In this session, we will talk about characteristics of parallel electric circuit. This session is divided in two parts. In the part 1, we will see the theoretical explanation, and in the part 2, we will study the FET simulation. In this video, we will be covering the part 1. So what is parallel electric circuit? So definition: when number of elements are connected between two common points so that voltage across each element is same, then that circuit is called as parallel electric circuit. So main requirement here is that all the elements should be connected between two common points. Now let us consider one example. So here three resistors R1, R2, R3 are connected between these two common points. So resistors R1, R2, R3 are said to be connected in parallel. Here we are connecting a DC voltage source V across this parallel combination. Now just for example, I have shown three resistors in parallel, but in general we can have two or more than two elements in parallel. One more important thing is that parallel electric circuit is applicable not only for resistors but also for other elements like inductors, capacitors, etc. So we can have a DC parallel circuit if we have a DC voltage source, or we can have AC parallel circuit if we have a AC voltage source. Now let us study the characteristics of parallel electric circuit. Characteristic number 1: voltage across each resistor is same. In this example, as we can see, if you measure the voltage across R1, R2 and R3, then these three resistors are connected between these two common points. So therefore, voltage across each resistor, it will be same, and here that voltage will be supply voltage capital V. So we can write capital V equal to voltage across R1, that is equal to voltage across R2, that is equal to voltage across R3. Reason is that they have two common points. Coming to the second characteristic, total current in the circuit is equal to the sum of currents in its parallel branches. Now let us consider with the help of same example, where three resistors R1, R2, R3 are connected in parallel across a DC voltage source capital V. So it is supplying a total current of capital I. Now some current will flow through R1, some current will flow through R2, and remaining will flow through R3. Let us call current flowing through R1 as I1, that flowing through R2 is I2, and remaining current flowing through R3 is I3. Now to determine relation between all these currents, we can apply Kirchhoff's current law at this node. Now Kirchhoff's current law states that the algebraic sum of incoming current towards the node is equal to the algebraic sum of outgoing current flowing away from the node. So here capital I is the incoming current, and outgoing currents are I1, I2 and I3, which are flowing away from the node. So if we apply KCL, we will get capital I equal to I1 plus I2 plus I3. So hence total current in the circuit is equal to sum of currents in its parallel branches. We can write mathematically capital I is I1 plus I2 plus I3. Third characteristic: reciprocal of total resistance, that is equivalent resistance, of parallel circuit is equal to the sum of reciprocal of individual resistances. So if we calculate the equivalent resistance of this parallel circuit where three resistors are in parallel, then we can write 1 upon RT, that is total resistance, is equal to 1 upon R1 plus 1 upon R2 plus 1 upon R3. Characteristic number 4: total resistance of parallel circuit is always smaller than the smallest resistance in the circuit. So what does it mean? Suppose there are three resistors R1, R2, R3 in parallel, and we will take one example here. Let R1 is 50 ohm, R2 is 80 ohm and R3 is 100 ohm, Now, if we calculate the equivalent resistance, then we know that 1 upon RT is 1 by 50 plus 1 by 80 plus 1 upon 100. Now, if you solve this, RT, that is equivalent resistance or total resistance, it is 23.53. Now, it is very obvious that equivalent resistance is smaller than the smallest. Now, smallest resistance is R1 here. So, this value 23.53, it is less than the 50. So, we can conclude that equivalent resistance of parallel is smaller than the smallest of resistors. That is characteristic number 4. Coming to the fifth characteristic, total power dissipated in parallel circuit is equal to the sum of power dissipated by each resistor. For example, again, if we consider the three resistors in parallel and if we calculate the total power dissipated in the circuit, we know that resistors dissipate the power. It does not store energy, it always dissipates the energy. Now, if you calculate the total power in this parallel circuit, then that total power dissipated will be equal to power taken by each resistor. That is total power PT equal to P1 plus P2 plus P3. Now, we will prove this statement. Now, we know that for the previous circuit where three resistors are connected in parallel, we can write 1 upon R equivalent or RT equal to 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus 1 by R3. Now, if I multiply both sides by square of the voltage, our original equation will remain same. So, V square into 1 upon RT equal to V square in bracket this whole term. Now, if you simplify this, so V square by RT equal to, if I multiply V square inside, so this will be equal to V square by R1 plus V square by R2 plus V square by R3. Now, what is V square by R? Now, we know that electric power P is equal to product of voltage into current. And by Ohm's law, current is voltage upon resistance. So, therefore, power is V square by R. So, what we can write here? V square by R1 is power taken by resistor R1. Similarly, V square by R2 is power taken by R2 and V square by R3 is power taken by R3 and V square by RT will be the total power taken PT. So, we can write PT equal to P1 plus P2 plus P3. So, hence we have proved this characteristic that total power dissipated in parallel circuit is equal to sum of power dissipated by each resistor. Coming to the last characteristic, characteristic number 6, as number of resistances connected in parallel increases, current flowing through the circuit increases. So, what does it mean? In order to understand this, again we will consider one example. Now, let supply voltage V equal to 100 volt and consider the first case where three resistors are connected in parallel. Their values are 50 ohm, 80 ohm and 100 ohm. Now, how much will be equivalent resistance? So, 1 by RT is 1 by 50 plus 1 by 80 plus 1 by 100. Now, if you solve this, RT, that is equivalent resistance or total resistance, you will get it as 23.53 ohm. Now, how much will be the total current? So, total current equal to V upon RT by Ohm's law, supply voltage by total resistance. Supply voltage we are assuming is 100. 100 divided by 23.53, it will be 4.25 ampere. Now, what this characteristic says, if number of resistors in parallel increases, so we will consider the second case where four resistors are connected in parallel. Now, for comparison, same R1, R2, R3 we will take and R4, let us say it is 40 ohm. Now, if you calculate the equivalent resistance, so 1 upon RT will be 1 by 50 plus 1 by 80 plus 1 by 100 plus 1 upon 40. Now, if you calculate this, RT will be equal to 14.81 ohm. Now, it is quite clear that as you go on increasing number of resistance in parallel, then your equivalent resistance will reduce. Now, if equivalent resistance reduces, obviously current will increase. Now, how much will be current? Again, by Ohm's law, current equal to voltage upon total resistance. So, 100 upon 14.81, that is equal to 6.75 ampere. Now, it is obvious that current in case 2 is more as compared to current in case 1. So, therefore, as number of resistors connected in parallel increases, current flowing through the circuit also increases. Reason is that because as number of resistance connected in parallel increases, equivalent resistance of circuit reduces. So this is characteristic number 6. So summarizing, these are the characteristics of parallel electric circuit. So in this video, we have considered the theoretical explanation of characteristics of parallel electric circuit. In the next video, we will be studying the FET simulation to understand the characteristics of parallel electric circuit. Thank you.